In this session, let's learn about parameter files. Yes, you are thinking, what are parameter files? These files are the ones which store all the database initialization parameters. Yes, if you take a person, what are the various parameters a person can have? He can have a height, weight, color, right? Like this, he can have various parameters. In the same way, a database can have its own set of parameters. And all those parameters are mentioned in this parameter file. These parameters, we call them as database initialization parameters. Okay, if you look here, these are all the various database initialization parameters. Yes, if you look at some of them, here we are mentioning what are the control files related to the database, what is the block size of the database, what is the database name, what is the recovery file destination, the total memory allocated, how many open cursors it can maintain, how many processes it can start, what is the undo retention time, what is the undo table space associated with it. And here you see there are various parameters related to various memory structures. Each parameter is defining the total memory size allocated to each memory structure. For Java pool, it allocated 4,194,000 bytes. For large pool, it allocated 8,388,000. In the same way, for shared global area, it allocated 545,259,520 bytes. In the same way, for streams pool, it allocated 4,194,304 bytes. Like this, various set of parameters are defined in a parameter file. And all these parameters are used by the database whenever it is starting up. And also, while performing various operations in the database, it requires these parameters. Okay? When the Oracle instance starts up, it reads this parameter file, and based on the information present in the parameter file, it will control the behavior of the database. Okay, example, if it reads open cursors are 300, then the Oracle instance makes sure only 300 cursors are opened at a given time. In the same way, if it says processes are 150, it makes sure only 150 processes are opened at a given time. Like this, depending upon the parameter, the database instance behavior is controlled. Okay, we have two types of parameter files. They are P file, which we call it as parameter file, and then SP file, which refers to server parameter file. The P file or the parameter file is the older way of maintaining the initialization parameters, and it is not recommended by Oracle. The newer way of maintaining a parameter file is SP file, and going forward from Oracle 9i, it is recommended to use the SP file. Let's see various differences between the P file and the SP file. The P file is a text-based file, whereas a SP file is a binary-based file. The next one, the parameters in the P file can be edited using a text editor. That means you can open the P file and manually edit them. But whereas a SP file, you cannot do it. Since it is a binary file, you cannot edit it using a text editor. If we have to configure the parameters in the SP file, we have to use the SQL statement alter system. Okay? And then the default location of the P file is in Oracle Home, DBS folder, and the P file looks like init and the SID name. Example, if our SID is prod1, then the parameter file name will be init.prod1.ora. Okay, the similar way, the SP file will also be present in the Oracle Home DBS folder, and the name will be like SP file and the SID. If our SID is prod1, then the SP file name will be SP file prod1.ora. Okay, and the final difference is using the RMAN utility, which is a recovery manager utility, we cannot take up the backup of a P file. But using the RMAN utility, you can take up the backup of a SP file. Okay, so it is strongly recommended that you go with SP files rather than P files. Now, how do you see if you are using a SP file or a P file? It's easy. By issuing the command show parameter SP file, you can find out if you are using a SP file or a P file. After issuing this command, if this query returns no rows, then you are using a P file or a parameter file. If it returns the file name, then you know you are using a SP file. Okay?